Lady May is a wondrous woman. Really, she's Lady Locksley, but everyone calls her Lady May.
Knows everyone is anyone in London. She could get you an investor at the drop of a hat.
Lady May, may I introduce my good friend Harry Selfridge?
Surely not the Selfridge we've all been hearing and reading about.
The very same.
Well, we are honored.
The honor's all mine. Lady May.
Is Lord Locksley in town?
No, Frank. Lord Locksley's in the country. Lord Locksley's generally in the country, and I'm generally in town. There are so many different ways to run a marriage, don't you think? And you never see each other. That's one of the very best.
I second that. Excuse me.
Come and sit down with me, Mr. Selfridge. So, you've been creating quite a stir, haven't you?
I certainly hope so.
And yet London doesn't seem to care for you much.
Oh, how do you make that out?
London doesn't like being shown how to do things, especially by outsiders.
Is that how you feel too?
Not necessarily. I rather like being shown how to do new things, especially by a man who knows what he's about. But people like us aren't used to going shopping. It's not considered smart. A gentleman will visit his tailor, a lady will send for her dressmaker, and so on.
We are going to have to change the fashion.
We? Oh, yes, of course. That's why you're here.
Oh, no. I never...
I do read the papers, Mr. Selfridge. You need a new backer, and you need him fast, or your visit to our little island will be cut rather short.
What you read in the papers ain't necessarily so, ma'am. But I am flattered that you take such an interest.
Well, we do like to give our ex-colonials a little helping hand when they need it.
Who says that I need a helping hand?
Everyone, Mr. Selfridge.
Lady May.
I'm surprised and flattered that you're here again so soon, Mr. Selfridge.
I wanted to introduce you to my friend, Lady May, Henri Leclerc, just arrived from America.
Are you an artist, Monsieur Leclerc? You have the look of one.
Actually, Henri is the best window display man in the world.
And here we all are. How delightful. What can I offer you, gentlemen? Champagne?
None for me, thanks. I don't drink.
I would be delighted.
We'll have champagne, please, Pimple, and coffee. Monsieur Leclerc, tell me what it is that you do.
I don't dress women like fashion designers do. I dress space.
Each Selfridge's window will be like a painting. And the people looking in, they imagine themselves in the story we are telling. Maybe in the window, there's a handsome young man and his beautiful lady. He's looking at her with passion. Maybe they're going motoring.
You'd put a motor car in the window.
Yeah, why not?
How fabulously extravagant. Who's driving? The lady or the gentleman?
That's a good question.
Well, I must say, Mr. Selfridge, yours does seem a thrilling enterprise.
One I would love to share with my friends.
And we must be the best of friends, mustn't we, Harry? Of course, a lady in my position occasionally needs a favor. I may call on you from time to time in that regard. Mightn't I?
One good turn always deserves another.
Then we understand each other. Are you fond of shooting?
Shooting?
I think you might enjoy it. Come down to the country with me on Friday. There's someone I'd like you to meet. Monsieur Leclerc, as you are a man of taste, will you make sure that Mr. Selfridge arrives in the latest knickerbockers?
Knickerbockers.
I do so enjoy a shapely calf.
I got straight with you, Selfridge. I choose my business ventures as I choose my horses. With the horses, I look them straight in the eye as I'm looking at you now, and I take a view. I'm generally right. But if I'm not, well, I don't waste time and straight off to the knacker's yard. I happen to think you're all right. And it turns out I'm wrong. All right.
All right, Mr. Musker.
Congratulations, Harry. Absolutely top-notch, the whole caboodle.
Mr. Selfridge, Musker and I are so pleased with what you've done with our store. We brought all our friends to see just how clever you are.
Why, thank you, Lady May.
Do encourage them to purchase before they go. Mr. Selfridge, you're the talk of the town.
That's what I aim for.
It's so thrilling to be involved in it all. Do you go boating, Mr. Selfridge? You know, the gentleman rows, and the lady holds the tiller. It's just a little bit of steering.
Morning.
Lady Locksley's in the Palm Court, Mr. Selfridge. She wants to see you.
Lady May, a delight to see you as always. How are you?
Feeling lonely, having argued with Tony over a large gambling debt.
Oh, well, you know how it is. Boys will be boys.
No, Harry, I don't. I'm not a member of your estimable sex.
It was a game. He lost, I won.
I found a backer for you. I'm helping your eldest daughter into society, and this is how you repay me. I won't be made a fool of.
How are you helping Rosalie?
Haven't you talked to Mrs. Selfridge recently? No, too busy hanging around the Gaiety. I thought you had better judgment than that.
My judgment is just fine.
Then it's time I asked for a favor. Cast your eye over this. It's utter nonsense, of course.
Suffrage women are some of the most elegant women I know.
So you support suffrage?
I live in a house of women. I have no choice. What can I do?
Actively endorse the cause. Sell our memorabilia.
These are Mrs. Pankhurst's colors. Doesn't she advocate violence?
Only as a last resort, when the men who oppose her are particularly intransigent. I would like a table reserved in this restaurant every Tuesday lunchtime for the London branch of the movement.
I would be honored.
I thought you would.
Mr. Coliano, Lady Locksley is requiring a large table every Tuesday.
Yes, Mr. Selfridge.
Who knows, you may have done me a favor. I'm rather bored with Tony, and there are other fish in the sea.